Stonehenge. Myth and legend have always surrounded its origins. It's been called both a healing site and a place of human sacrifice. Was it a calendar or a stellar observatory? Its construction has been attributed to druids, the wizard Merlin, and even aliens. For centuries, historians have fiercely debated the site's true purpose. But now, for the first time ever, they're coming close to solving the enigma. Cutting-edge technology is revealing secret markings etched into the stones. Nearby, the revelation of other hidden monuments is rewriting everything we thought we knew. Hello, Josh.
Hi, Josh. I'm Mike.
Mike, nice to meet you.
Hi, Susan.
Susan.
Hi, Rupert.
Rupert, pleasure. Mike Parker Pearson is a leading expert in the archaeology of Stonehenge, and his recent findings are the reason I'm here. But first, I ask him for a bit of Stonehenge 101. So what is a henge? It's not the stones, right?
No, a henge is actually an earthen enclosure with a ditch and a bank.
So if these stones weren't here, this would still be a henge?
It's still a henge, because there is a bank and ditch outside of it.
So that's one mystery solved. Stonehenge isn't just a name. It's a description of a stone circle inside a henge that ancient peoples managed to plan and construct in stages between 4 and 5,000 years ago. Historian Susan Greeny has studied how they might have done it.
The smaller stones you can see around us here, these have been brought from southwest Wales, about 180 miles away, and we think they've been brought by the sea, by boats, and then overland to Stonehenge.
That's crazy. Considering the complexity and the difficulty of the engineering, do you think there was some centralized power conducting this?
I think there has to be. This is a work of genius. There's so much thought that has gone into every single bit of it. The evidence we have is that this may well have been a moment of cohesion where people are bringing autonomous groups together to all act in synchrony.
Mike tells me that 5 millennia ago, Britain was populated by disparate groups of people who were finally making the transition from hunting and gathering to farming. These weren't rogue druids like Spinal Tap would have you believe. Druids didn't even exist until thousands of years later. No, these were surprisingly advanced Stone Age or Neolithic people who started working together on this massive project. But its biggest mystery remains. What the hell is it for? For decades, many focused on the site's entrance. It's aligned with the rising sun on the summer solstice, so many believed it was intended as an astronomical worship or celebration site. But recently, an investigation turned up a macabre find that began to change the accepted view of Stonehenge.
When we dug here, what we found was human remains. That was just a fraction of the number of people who were buried here. This place was full of the cremated remains of the dead. It's basically the largest cemetery within Britain for the whole of the 3rd millennium BC.
Incredible. So Stonehenge was much more than some ancient stargazing site. It also appears to be a massive graveyard. The connection between the two functions has remained elusive, but in recent years, the magic of technology has helped experts crack the code. English Heritage, which maintains the site, has been working on the most detailed scans of the monument ever conducted. The team behind the tech is here today.
This is Stephen.
Hey, Stephen.
Antonio.
Hi. Antonio, nice to meet you. Josh.
Hi, Antonio.
How are you? Pleasure to meet you. They've been using 3D scanners that shower the area with lasers, mapping and measuring every detail of the landscape down to fractions of a millimeter. Some are mounted on tripods, but others, like the Leica Pegasus backpack, are a bit more mobile. That's a Dalek from Doctor Who, correct?
Correct, yes. Wearable Dalek.
What is this thing?
It's a mobile mapping unit. Do you want to have a go?
Oh, for sure. I'd love to. This is the coolest backpack I've ever seen. So if I were to break this, what is the value of this thing I'm wearing?
It's about $200,000.
Well, it sounded a lot like you said $200,000.
I did indeed.
This is literally worth more than everything that I own. I walk through the monument with a laser scanner. Talk about doing work on the go. This thing has 32 individual lasers on board that are capable of capturing 500,000 data points every second. And the onboard cameras are able to see every single time I take a step, generating 25 megs of data every meter that I walk forward. In other words, this thing is able to see everything. In the most recent rounds of scans, English Heritage generated an incredible 850 gigabytes of data, which has started to settle long simmering debates about the site's original function.
So the scan showed us that particularly in this direction where the sun sets in midwinter, along the solstice alignment, the stones were shaped much more carefully than some of the other stones.
The scans reveal that special care was used in constructing and refining a specific viewing alignment, not just the summer solstice, but in fact, completely the opposite. Stonehenge seems to instead have been built to channel the sunset on the shortest day of the year.
We've all been thinking about the midsummer sunrise, but it now looks as though the most important direction of sight is through that gap, towards the midwinter sunset.
Far from being an altar to worship the gods who brought the light and warmth of summer, Stonehenge appears to have been made for the dark cold of an English winter. And that's not all the data has shown.
One of the things the laser scanner also shows us is the detail of the dressing of the stones. And when I say dressing, what we mean is the way that the stones were worked and they were shaped using hammerstone. You can see here these mushroom shapes. So these are all axes.
Look at that! That is spectacular.
The amazing detail uncovered 72 never-before-seen symbols carved into the stones.
Oh, here.
That's right.
Though more recent than the original construction, the carvings here serve as a sort of nail in the coffin for what Stonehenge was really for.
We only find carved axes on slabs associated with burials.
This, along with the winter solstice alignment, supports Mike's theory that Stonehenge was actually built as a monument to the ancestors, a so-called land of the dead. In and of itself, this is a bombshell revelation for a site once thought to be a simple calendar or a place of celebrations. But the question remains, why was Stonehenge built in this particular spot? What makes this place special? Mike leads me outside the stone circle to reveal another amazing find.
Do you notice anything weird out here?
Well, you've got this kind of ditch mound here?
That's it. These banks are natural landforms.
The natural formation that was here sits in an alignment with the stars and sun above. To the builders of Stonehenge, this made for the perfect spot to erect their monument.
What they did when they built Stonehenge was to embellish this natural feature that matches the movement of the heavens. This may have been the center of their cosmos.
Does it lead anywhere?
Down to the valley, over that ridge, there we found another henge, which has come to be known as Superhenge.
I'm sorry, did he just say Superhenge?
Josh, this is Superhenge.
Look at that. It's massive.
Yes, it is the largest henge in the world.
Incredible.
Nearly 2 miles away, northeast of Stonehenge, is an enormous bank and ditch construction, with walls nearly 10 feet tall and a diameter of 1,600 feet across. It's more than 5 times the size of the earthworks at Stonehenge.
But what I do not see are any stones.
Yeah, this is all about timber.
Archaeologists here discovered a timber circle, then another, then a third.
And then this last year, we discovered that the whole thing was surrounded by a giant timber circle.
Wow.
1,200 feet in diameter, probably more than 300 giant posts. Posts the size of totem poles.
That is extraordinary.
This was a sophisticated civilization, but it's just one small part of what's going on in this landscape back in prehistory.
From Superhenge, we fly on to Salisbury Hill, the tallest man-made mound in Europe. Finally, we come upon the site that Mike is most excited about showing me.
Josh, you see this town up ahead of us?
Yes.
Do you notice anything strange about it?
It's got a circle around it.
Yeah, it's sat inside a henge.
Oh my God, look at that.
This is the town of Avebury, which sits inside the largest stone circle in the world, 16 times bigger than Stonehenge. It originally had 98 sarsen slabs running around the edge.